2 a.m. I was up a little after 1, and that was substantial sleep, so we're starting a new vlog today. Well, at least we are, so long as I can stay awake long enough. We'll get a nice rainstorm coming in. It's been raining for a while, actually. Looks like we got some puddles. Hopefully nobody's dealing with flooding. That's too bad, but for me, this is nice because it's getting some more humid air in. How's my head? The headache persists. It's mild. I had the windows closed all night, so I'm trying to mitigate the problem by standing in the window. I've got, it seems like some cats have been hanging out over here, so it's maybe not the best spot to breathe, but, at least not for the night. A little bit clearer over here. Yeah. I'm just trying to get some fresh air, and, it is largely working. It's mostly more like cut grass over here. My broken eggs have left me with a little bit of a conundrum, in that they're going to, size out my breakdown. As everybody else, I buy eggs in the dozen. Yes, that's right. I'm not that special. I buy eggs by the dozen, just like you do. But that means I have them 4 at a time, so if I lose 2, then that means that my normally clean breakdown of 3 meals per carton has been abolished. And I'm going to be stuck mixing over cartons, and I don't like that. So instead, I'm going to eat like a snake this morning. Yes, this is what's going on this morning. I'm eating like a snake. We're gonna have a nice big egg meal along with a bagel and the other regular things. So I'm going to eat well. Hopefully that actually helps. Because with all of the not being able to stay awake over the last couple of days, I kind of missed a little bit of eating. So this is actually a catch-up. I should have had this yesterday. So it works out all right. It's a meal and a half. We're going to end up with 6 of them eggs. Oh, sorry, 7. Yeah. This is one actually in that margarine container that I managed to salvage. There were 2 broken eggs. One of them was too far gone. The other one was just... in need of immediate attention. So, if the problem is the air quality in the basement, what am I going to do? Am I just going to have the windows open all the time? Well, I think one of the problems is probably that it's dry. I mean, obviously, I've got some kind of contaminants of some sort, whether it's natural gas or sewer gas, which are basically the same thing. There is something in the air that my body does not like, but at the same time, I think that if I could increase the humidity level in the basement a little bit, It would probably do me a lot of good in being able to breathe down here. One way to do that is actually to shower more often. Yeah. But I'm thinking I'm probably going to go ahead and splurge on a little dehumidifier. I was thinking about a couple of shows this week, but the weather is. It's gonna be nice today, right? And tomorrow. And it's gonna. If I can believe the weather forecast, I'm looking at about a 20 degree plunge starting. And that's gonna be great for my head, too, right? These massive shifts in pressure and temperature, all rain, low pressure. We know that affects my head too, right? And let's remember that the purpose of these recordings remains and always was and remains to document myself as a composer, not to entertain you. You're not important. I don't give a fuck what you think. I'm not here for your amusement. I don't even wear teen spirit. So, I'm not here to entertain you. I wear lady speeds today. I like the fruity flavors, or the fruity smells. I like broadly speaking, I like to smell fairly fruity. That's a broad truth of my existence. If I'm not getting any work done because my head hurts, then it's important to document that. So, if you don't want to listen to me whine, you can go the fuck away. How about that? Huh? If you don't want to listen to me, then get the fuck out of here. Okay then. Yeah, I think the humidifier might be a serious. Oh, I was talking about, yeah. Okay, so the temperature, it's just the way that it's gonna fall. It's like it's gonna fall. I was hoping to go to a show tomorrow night, and then on Friday night, and then on, no, sorry, tomorrow night, then on Thursday night, and then on Saturday night. But the way that they have the weather forecast is that it's gonna go from like beautiful, nice day tomorrow afternoon to like below freezing right when I'm gonna go. So I can't go tomorrow because it's gonna be like freezing. And then the cold snap lasts until Sunday morning. So this week's worth of shows seems to be wiped out by the weather. There's nothing that's compelling enough to pull me out, right? Nothing like the Cloud Nothing show, where, you know, it's one of them is some kind of a post-punk thing from New York, which would be nice, a nice walk on a nice day, but I don't want to. Again, you're looking at like minus 10 wind chills, like the north wind blows. This is the Archie blows, you know, like I don't want to go out in that. I have enough. You know what it really basically comes down to is I have respect for the weather. I'm a Canadian. You should know that by now. And I have a lot of respect for these weather systems when they decide they want to come in. And when that north wind decides it wants to come in, I'm not, you know, I'm not playing chicken with the north wind. You know, that's not something I'm doing. It's if it's coming down, it's coming down, and I'm getting out of its way. That's something every good Canadian knows, is that you don't play with the north wind. The north wind is stronger than you. The north wind will destroy you, and there's no use in pretending otherwise. You will not overcome the north wind. You will not conquer it. You will not defeat it. It will beat you down and make you cry. So, I it's and this is one of these nights, where it'll be almost t-shirt weather at noon, and then by midnight, It'll be like a legit blizzard. So, minus 10 degree wind chills, north wind pounding down from the top there. You don't want to go out in that. So, that scratches Monday off. And then, sorry, that scratches Wednesday off. I'm thinking the beginning of the month, the beginning of the week. And then I got the beginnings. I got the beginnings all mixed up there. And yeah, so that scratches off Wednesday night, and then Thursday is like the lows coming in, right? So it might not be quite as windy, but it's gonna be yucky, and I might have to deal with some snow. I don't want to deal with that. And then the whole Saturday was supposed to be like a late night drum and bass night. There's still some possibility I could make it for Saturday night. Still some possibility. If the warm front comes in a few hours early, it could happen. But I mean, the whole point was I'm going out for the night, right? So that was it was the dance party was going to be open, but like fucking dancing until 7 in the morning type of thing, right? Like all night dancing. But if it's going to be cold, then that defeats the point. So that's a no-no as well. But I mean, like I say, that could still come back. And then we're gonna get a couple of nice days again, and let's say those are the days I don't want to go out, and then like cold. This has been hounding me for the last couple of weeks. It's that whenever I want to go out anywhere, it gets cold, and when I don't want to go anywhere, it's warm. So it's like I'm never leaving the house. And it might have something to do with the like just the depth of the effect that the air is having on, or that the air quality is having on me, is that I'm not going outside because all the things I'd want to do are on the days where it's too cold to go out, and on the days where it's nice, there's nothing to do. And I mean, I'm not the type of person that's just gonna go outside because it's nice out. Hey guys, look, it's a cloud. Hey, a cloud. Let's vlog it as a cloud. You know, it's like I don't want to sit outside. I got things to read. I got stuff to write. I'll waste my time outside in the sun. Fucking stupid. So, yeah, it's just stuck, right? So, I just wanted to present an update. I think I've kind of lost my point here. How's my head been over the almost 14 minutes that we've been talking? It's been up and down. Again, you'll notice that I keep going back to the window. There's a reason for that, and that's because the fresh air is making a difference substantially. I don't know. I obviously have a lot of experimenting to do to determine exactly what the fuck. It could end up being that I'm allergic to something in here, and the fresh air is clearing my sinuses, right? That could be it too. So I'd have to figure out what it is that's causing the problem in here. It's obviously not solely the dry air. It's obviously something more to it than that, but if I do get a humidifier in here and it does help, then I think that I kind of need one down here anyways. It's too dry down here. But yeah, so I'm gonna make like a snake and eat my eggs here. One egg, two egg, three egg, ha ha ha. Four egg, five egg, six egg, seven egg. Eggs are actually very good for you, and I think we've been over this. So don't worry about me and my eggs. Me and my eggs. Don't you worry about me and my eggs. This is actually the second thunderstorm of the year. I'm standing here on the morning of March 1st and talking about the second thunderstorm of the year. And we got a few nasty claps here. Normally at this time of year, again, I'm from Ottawa. Oh, the fresh air feels good. Again, I'm from Ottawa. So my timeline may be a little off, but normally at this time of year, I'm expecting the snow to start melting, barely. Normally there's still a couple blizzards to come. There's lightning. Are we gonna slap here? We don't normally usually even get, yeah, holy cow. We don't even normally usually get thunderstorms like this in April. This is like late May. Our thunderstorm season here is more like August. This is unusual, to say the least. Some years at the first day of March, you'd have snowbanks up into your waist. If you think the times, they ain't changing. The times, they ain't changing, alright. Yes, sir. Nothing in the air here this morning. Kinda wish there was, though. My head could use some. But yeah, it's, unusual, to say the least. Alright, well. A little after 8, and well, I napped a little this morning. I haven't actually got anything done yet. And I'm not exactly the most energetic that I've ever been. I have to say that my headache is at least. It came and went. And I'm actually... I took some aspirin. Remember, I took some aspirin yesterday, too. Now, this is my thinking, and let's remember, I'm not a doctor. I pointed this out the other day. So don't take this as medical advice. Take this as somebody that's recording their thoughts. You're not supposed to listen to what I say and say, I should do that, too. You're supposed to listen. You're supposed to understand this as historical documentation. This is meaningful to me and to scholars of me. It's not meant as medical advice. But this is my understanding of the thing. Aspirin as an anti-inflammatory agent should work fairly quickly. So if you've got a headache, the aspirin should work within about 20 minutes or so, certainly within an hour, and you should need to take it frequently, right? So you should need to repeat your dose within a few hours. That was my expectation, right? And so that's why I went to the hospital in the morning, was because I said, okay, I took some aspirin, it's been an hour almost, I've got no reaction. This isn't working. I'm going to the hospital. But then when I'm at the hospital, it starts to work. Well, I also got some fresh air. So this is the two things, right? I got some fresh air, and I took some aspirin. So the combination of these things started to work. And we don't know right now which one is in a larger proportion. But what that would suggest, I mean, not only did it start to work, but it worked for a long period, right? I didn't have a headache again until I woke up, which was almost 24 hours later. What that would suggest is that it's not the reason the if the aspirin had a level of effectiveness, and the reason the aspirin had a level of effectiveness was not because it was acting as an anti-inflammatory agent, but because it was acting as a blood thinner. Because that's the part of aspirin that stays for a longer period. And what that would suggest to me is that I've got a blood clot in my head. And maybe the blood clot is putting pressure on my sinuses, or maybe it's even putting pressure on a tumor, who knows? But if the effects of aspirin that I'm feeling are take a long time to work and are long-lived, then that's the blood thinner aspect of the drug, meaning that I'm feeling better because it's taking something out. Now, I guess there's a few different ways to work that out, right? You could argue that I got a blood clot from smoking, but that doesn't really add up. You could argue that I had a head injury and I've got a blood and it clotted. Maybe it just clotted a little bit too much, so the aspirin is working. Or like I think you could argue that there's a tumor or something or whatever else it is, right? Now, I need to be clear still that we've got two things here, right? We've got fresh air and we've got aspirin. I want to point something else out though, which is that for the first time, I'm noticing a little bit of bruising around my eyebrow. It could be very well be the case that bruising has something to do with the aspirin. But I would be more likely to suggest that that's positive at this point. Well, a muted positive, right? What does that mean? Well, I've got myself on notice, right? I'm going to monitor myself for the next little while. And we'll see what the results are. I have to say that if I still need to take aspirin a week from now, then I will agree to a CAT scan. To determine the extent of the bleeding or the clotting, and what it is that I should do next. But I think that the broad truth of it is that if I have an issue with a clot in my brain or in the front of my forehead, the best thing I can do is take aspirin anyways. The most complicated issue I have in front of me is trying to separate these variables. How do I determine if the issue in front of me is related to clotting? Or sorry, how do I determine if the solution to the issue in front of me is due to aspirin primarily, or due to fresh air primarily, or due to both, so long as I open the windows whenever I take the aspirin? Because I did both again this morning, right? Yesterday I took the aspirin, it didn't work, so I opened the windows and I went for a walk. Today, I opened the windows and it was a little slow to working, so I took the aspirin. Right now, I'm really leaning towards it being the aspirin that's the dominant effective part. But like I say, it's not due to its anti-inflammatory aspect, but due to its blood thinning How's the cough? It's very dull. Still there. It's not a problem. The temperature is about to turn for the next few days, as I mentioned. And I'm going to leave the windows open for today because I'm going to hope I can get a little bit of work done. I'm feeling alert enough. I'm going to do these dishes here. It's dark because I've got the... I'm going to try to avoid those lights because that's another issue that could create headaches. So I've got some dishes to do. And it'll be in the evening, I guess, that I'm going to want to get these closed. And then I fully expect that I will wake up with a headache, and I will take only the aspirin, because it'll be too cold to open the windows. And I'll have to give it some time, but ultimately we'll see. What happens. Now, I need to be clear, I'm not, even with the aspirin, what I have right now is a relief, right? I'm not, at full strength by any means. There is still kind of a dull background headache, same thing as yesterday. Like, it's not completely gone, but, seems like it's enough, right? It's relief. But I do think that the situation is I think I have enough evidence at this point to be concerned enough about the seriousness of the issue to take the CAT scan if this is still an issue. Why don't we do it like this? I'm gonna have to get my blood taken soon too. Ooh, that's an issue. Ah, because I'm taking aspirin. I'm gonna bleed to death at the fucking blood clinic. I understand that I'm a machine, but I don't like to treat my body that way. Or if I do, I kind of like to take a hands-off approach. I don't like this idea of, you know, inject some platelets, and then inject some blood thinners, and then, you know, as though I'm just a bunch of chemical reactions, even though I know that I really am just a bunch of chemical reactions. You know, there's a... It's not even a question of mysticism. It's more just like, I understand that things are in an equilibrium. And, I'll admit it. I don't have faith in many things in this world. I don't have faith in people. I don't have faith in government. I certainly don't have faith in God. But I seem to have faith in DNA, in biology. You know, those... I lost the word. Those A's and D's and G's and T's, they know what they're doing. Even when they fuck up, they tend to... Well, no, they don't. And they do fuck up really frequently, don't they? Regardless, I have faith in them to kind of get the broad idea right. I guess we all need to have faith in something, right? We'd be pretty dour if we didn't. You know, like I say, I don't have faith in people. I don't have faith in governments. I don't have faith in markets. I don't have faith in God. But I have faith in biology for some reason. It's just like it's... I wanna propose a policy of non-interference. You know, it's the more you interfere, the more you're likely to fuck it up kind of thing. You gotta go in there when you have to, you know. It's a minimal, minimal biological interference. That's my thing. I'm gonna have to get a blood test before I go to see a doctor on, I believe it's March the 6th. Which, actually, today is the 1st. Meaning, I guess I should probably go on Friday. That's the, And if I still got these issues at that point, I will go back. I will have a talk with my doctor. And, that's what we should do. Have a talk with my doctor, and, if he thinks, I mean, I don't want to be an ass, but I don't exactly have much faith in my doctor either. At the very least, maybe you can give me a little bit of an opinion on what he thinks about the different things. And I can use it as a bit of a goalpost, right? Because I don't want to be, I don't want to be in a situation where it's like, I'm at the hospital, it's like, I have an appointment with my doctor tomorrow. And then I'll be like, why don't you just see your fucking doctor, you fucking idiot. So, I'll wait until I see the doctor first, and then, okay. I'm glad we had this talk. I've worked this out now. It seems like I'm plotting. I'm a dour empiricist, and the evidence in front of me is fairly clear. I'm plotting. That's what it seems like. And, that puts me at a risk for stroke. But I mean, like, the... My understanding is there's two ways you can deal with the clotting, if you notice it. You can do what I'm doing right now, which is take aspirin, and thank God it's working. Or I can go for brain surgery. Oh, that'd be fine. No, thank you. No, sir. No. I'll turn that off for a minute while we have a little talk here. It's almost 4 o'clock. And I've got the windows just closed a few seconds ago because, those clouds are looking kind of ominous. We are dealing with a smashing together of hot and warm fronts. And for those of you that are amateur meteorologists, you know that that's when tornadoes come in. So, I've been making progress this afternoon. What I've been doing is I've been going through and searching for full sets. I created a second, I don't know if we even went over this, but I created a second playlist. And the second playlist has representations. I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna sound like a mathematician. It has representations that are isomorphic. In fact, they're not isomorphic, because they're not even close to replicas, largely, but they're, I'm trying to get at least full concerts that are on the same tour, right? So I can't find any. One of the shows that I enjoyed more than the others in the summer of 2011, just as an example, and in fact, I think this is the reason I created the list, was I enjoyed a band called Animal Faces from Toronto. And it was a little bit before they did have a moment where they were selling some records in, I think, 2012. Although I think they faded away from that. When I saw them again, I saw them open for Pile in 2015, and nobody knew who they were then. They seemed to kind of actually want to be getting away from the sound they were doing in 2011. But that was a set I enjoyed, and I wanted it to be in the list. Because I enjoyed it and I remembered it, and I think it gives me a little bit of that fancy cred there. There were like 20 people there. I think I was the only person there to see that band. And like I said, they did. If you like that specific type of punk, they did get a little bit of of a break a few years later. So I wanted a list of just kind of representations. Like, if I can't find footage for the actual show, or the only footage I can find is kind of crappy, well, now I've got a list of mostly full sets, or lengthy captures anyways. Of shows that I've seen. So I stopped there at the same point that I stopped the main reconstruction, which was, I think, it was the beginning of 2012, and I'm actually almost caught up on that. So I went through all 2012, 13, 14, and most of 15. I also have to go through 16 and the very beginning of 17. But I'm almost there on that. So I got a little bit of progress, but as soon as I close the windows, my head, I think that the best way I should say this is that I felt a pressure shift. I'm not about to get into a headache or anything. At least I hope not, but I did feel the pressure change, and that's worrying to me, because I don't want to be taking a lot of aspirin for obvious reasons. I want to develop a cause and effect, right? But if the first thing I do when I close the window is I notice that my head starts to go, then the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pop some aspirin, because I'm going to want to control for that, right? That's the perfect experiment, right? If I notice that my headache starts to go as soon as I close the window, then if the aspirin resolves it, then I notice the aspirin, and if it doesn't, I notice the wind. But I am concerned about taking too much, right? I think I'm a long way before I have any real concern, but I wanted to give myself more than, you know. I was hoping I could start the experiment in the morning. In fact, I may end up pushing myself to bed early. The consequence of that. I've stopped to eat. That's my goal here. Although I should point out that I don't. If I really actually am dealing with a blood clot in my forehead, I don't know what the consequences of letting it come up and down are, right? Like, I don't want to let it clot and then unclot and let it clot and then unclot, right? You would think I would want to aggressively address it, right? What I can say is I can assure you that whatever the issue is not fully resolved. And I am no doubt going to be dealing with something or other this evening or in the morning. But this is my update. If I do end up dead of a stroke overnight, then this is what I've done. I've closed the windows. Like I say, I think the best way to state it is that I noticed an immediate shift in pressure, which you would notice. It's clear as day. And I'm gonna finish. Remember my 7 eggs this morning? Well, that's all that's left of it. I just want to get that in me before I take my pills, so I'm going to get to that. Like I say, hopefully I'm still here to talk to you in the morning. My gut is signaling to me that I have reasons to be concerned that I might not be. We'll find out, eh?